Hi guys, it's me, Geneva DiGrecia, and welcome to my channel. So, for today's video, I am going to introduce to you one of the social dance called Cha-Cha. So, before I will show you my own performance in Cha-Cha dance, first, I would like to explain to you its origin, its history, and the purpose of its dance. So guys, I hope you will like my performance on this vlog. So defining Cha-Cha, it is fast rhythmic ballroom dance of Latin American region with the basic pattern of three steps and a shuffle. The Cha-Cha is a dance of Cuban origin. The Cha-Cha is a playful and flirtatious dance known for its vibrant energy. Although it is traditionally danced to pop-up music, with a Latin or Cuban beat today, it is common to dance the cha-cha to many current styles of music. The cha-cha is a dance that descended from another partner dance known as the mambo. While the music of mambo dancing comes from old traditions rooted in the heart of Africa, mambo dancing itself was born in Cuba and the cha-cha developed alongside it. Havana, Cuba was a very happening place in 1940s and 1950s. It was extremely popular for the rich and famous to go and spend time in Havana resorts. Influential writers such as Ernest Hemingway and Tennessee Williams had experiences in Cuba that shaped their monumental novels, and the famous Broadway Guys and Dolls was set in Havana, Cuba. The cha-cha was originally one of the figures within the mambo, with three quicker steps followed, two slower steps, and weight was changed on each step. These mambo patterns became the basic steps for the cha-cha. Being born out of mambo dancing, the popular Latin dance technique like mambo dancers, cha-cha dancers keep their feet close to the floor, move their hips a lot while keeping their upper bodies erect. In the 1950s, cha-cha dancing started to spread internationally. 1952, English dance teacher Pierre Lavelle went to Cuba and brought back his version of the cha-cha to the British Isles. There are many beliefs on how the cha-cha dance got its name. Some suggest that the name of the cha-cha dance can be traced back to the religious ritual dances of the West Indians. There is a West Indies plant known to produce seed pods called chachas. These seeds are used to make small rituals, also known as chachas, and in Haiti, traditional voodoo buds consist of musicians playing the cha-cha rattle. But cha-cha rattle, cha-cha dancing, go its name. So others suggest that cha-cha dancing was originally called the cha-cha-cha after the sound of the dancer's shoes as they shuffle around the dance floor. Regardless of how the cha-cha dance got its name, the term cha-cha grew to be recognized and known on a global scale as a lively partner dance.
Sway, like a flower bending in the breeze.
By hearing the word cha-cha gives me an unfamiliar feeling. Well, we all hear those terms, especially during dance competition, and I really think that it's super easy, as peace as cake. As I tried executing the steps, I was caught on guard from the reasons that I can't properly perform the footwork with its hand gesture. It was really difficult for me to dance cha-cha, and the struggle I encountered has never been easy. Well, maybe the advantage I can say for the dance is the dance style is quite familiar for me, and the song also, it was so catchy and easily to adopt. And maybe the disadvantages I encountered for the whole performance may be my kind of clarifying my footwork. So it was the clarification of my footworks, because it's really hard to keep simultaneous moves on the steps. To sum it up, maybe I must say I should practice more footworks and maybe my hand coordination also, as my hand movements are always been in a bit in performing cha-cha dance. So that's all I can say. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Hoping you really enjoy this show, and I am also praying that you learned something about this vlog of mine for today. So stay safe, guys. Stay at home, and God bless you always. Annyeong.